'Cause you're falling.
I'm at backstage with Starter because they are going to perform a sold-out show tonight. Hi, Dustin.
Hi.
So your band is from Columbus, Ohio. Do you still live there?
I do, actually. People ask me all the time why we haven't moved to LA or something. But it's kind of, it's an amazing city, actually. So I'll probably stay there forever.
And how is the musical scene there? How can we imagine it? Yeah. Is it rich?
It's great. 21 Pilots is from there, so I always make the joke that we'll never be the biggest band from Columbus, unfortunately, but yeah, it's got a great scene.
So you have a degree in electrical engineering, and you also studied at the International Space University. Mm-hmm. When have you decided that you would rather be a musician?
I actually did both concurrently. I did music since I've been a little kid, and I got a record deal with Epic Records, and eventually that went away, and I had already stopped my PhD, so Starset is the merging of those two passions, and it just worked out.
And your music and your albums are also built around Starset's community. How can we imagine this community? What is the brief explanation of it?
Well, one of the missions of the Starset Society is to promote science and technology, but also the effects it has on society as well, positive and negative. And there's also a futurism element to it, and that feeds the sci-fi aspect. So there's a science and a sci-fi aspect. I like to say we're sort of the, there are parallels to like a Christian band, but we're that for science and tech.
When can we expect the fourth album?
It won't be too long before a fourth album. I am writing it as well. In fact, someone will be arriving tomorrow morning to help me to work on it. I'm working on it while on tour. So yeah, in the past, it's been up to 2 years between albums. This one won't, the fourth one won't take as long.
Why do you call your concerts demonstrations? What is the reason of that?
One reason is they are more immersive than a typical concert. The experience starts at the door, especially when we're in the U.S. There are there's video content and immersion right as you walk in. There are posters that have augmented reality to them, so if you have our app, you can experience the augmented reality. It's to a greater degree in the U.S., but here as well. On Rebel shows, for instance, we have two different types of show, and on the Rebel demonstration, you get a pamphlet that explains some of the narrative to you. And in addition to that, we're also demonstrating some of the aspects of Starset in the narrative.
And sometimes you also cover songs, for example, from Led Zeppelin and AC/DC. So are these classical rock and roll bands are an inspiration as well for you?
Kashmir itself was inspirational. It was cinematic. When I first heard it, you know, with the cellos and the strings and the violins in with the rock, that definitely struck a chord with me. And I think it's probably the earliest example of cinematic rock that I was ever exposed to. So it's cool to be covering it and paying homage.
And what about AC/DC?
AC/DC is just for the rock people, but doing its spin with it, you know, having Siobhan on violin, it gives it its own Starset flavor. But, you know, you can't go wrong with an AC/DC song.
What can the Hungarian audience expect from tonight's show?
To have their minds blown and their heads exploded. No, I'm just kidding. No, it'll be a it'll be a good one, especially when I know that they're going to bring the energy and we feed off of that. Especially when shows are sold out, there's just a next level of energy. So it's going to be good.